So before we proceed, let's read this. Laburnum, a short tree with hanging branches, yellow flowers and poisonous seeds. Goldfinch, a small singing bird with yellow feathers on its wings. So you might have noticed that yellow color is dominating in the first stanza. I have already explained the first stanza. Now I am going to explain the second stanza. In the second stanza, the poet has beautifully described the arrival of goldfinch, the bird, and its effects on the tree. So let's read. Till the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup, a suddenness, a startlement at a branch end. The tree, the laburnum tree, is motionless, is silent, as if it is soulless. Till the time the goldfinch comes. Till the bird arrives with a twitching chirrup. It arrives with a twitching chirrup, intermittently making short high-pitched sounds. A suddenness, a startlement at a branch end. She appears all of a sudden at the branch end of the tree. All of a sudden, a suddenness, a startlement, unexpectedly. This is how she arrives at the branch end of the tree. Then sleek as a lizard and alert and abrupt, she enters the thickness, and here the sleekness of the bird has been compared to the lizard. So, simile, sleek as a lizard. Here the poetic device which has been used is simile. Alert, she is very vigilant, watchful, and abrupt, and her movements are abrupt, quick, swift movements. Like that she enters the thickness, abruptly, being alert, watchful, and with quick movements, swiftly she enters the thickness of the tree. And a machine starts up, of chitterings, and a tremor of wings and trillings. The whole tree trembles and thrills. When she enters the thickness, the sounds made by the young ones, her young ones, sounds of chitterings, tremor of wings, that is flapping of wings, trillings, all kind of sounds they were making, chirping, which has been compared to a machine, as if a machine started up. It is metaphor because it has been assumed as machine, indirectly been compared with the machine. So the sudden chitterings of the young ones in the nest are sounding as the machine has started up, noisy chirpings and flapping of wings. So the whole tree trembles and thrills, and because of that the whole tree seems to come alive. The whole tree trembles and thrills. In this, the tree has been personified, because trembling, thrilling, these are the characteristics of human. So personification poetic device has been used here for tree. In the beginning also, the laburnum top is silent, the tree is silent. Silent is again an attribution of a personal nature, that means a human characteristic. So again, that is personification. Now in this stanza, in the second stanza, alliteration can be seen here. Alliteration, that is the sound of the initial letter repeating in the neighboring words. So suddenness, startlement, SS, sound of S is repeating. So this is alliteration. Then here simile, I have already told. And alert and abrupt, AAA. Tree trembles, TT. Then that is it. And if you find more, you can just mention those poetic devices in your notebook.